Joseph Paul Wyckoff. I did not know Ed Wyckoff well. I don't know, for instance, the story behind all those names. I knew Ed because I dated one of his roommates sophomore year. I remember Ed because he was quiet and he was hilarious. A couple of my favorite stories from college, repeated regularly over the years, have Ed's name attached. So I wanted to say a few words today about Ed. Ed Wyckoff was brilliant. So what? I hear you all thinking. Ed Wyckoff was funny. That puts him in rare company. Ed Wyckoff was humble. Ed was silent for our first few class reports. But by the 20th, he wanted to let us know about his family, his life enriched by marriage and the birth of a son. He was also clearly gratified by his career in financial aid counseling, providing service to students at the University of New Mexico's medical school. By the 25th anniversary report, Ed had undergone surgery for esophageal cancer. His wife also had medical issues. Throughout, they found strength and cheer in their son. In Ed's words, quote, "Now a delightful 9-year-old with a precocious intellect and an endearing gentleness of soul," end quote. Aptly, it seems, they had also given this little Ed his father's name. Ed's other news in the 25th report was that in 2003, he had received the University of New Mexico Student Services Award based on 70 letters of nomination written by students he had worked with. His Albuquerque Journal obituary contained quotes from some of these letters, and I will share just one that sums up the overall sentiment. Quote, "When I graduate medical school, I will reflect on people whom I consider essential supports, and Ed Wyckoff is already on the top of that list," end quote. Now, for our 35th reunion report, Ed is silent again. His quiet voice will be missed. Ed saved lives figuratively by guiding students through a stressful and difficult aid awarding process. And Ed is now literally, though indirectly, saving lives through those doctors he helped to finish school. I don't know who wrote the obituary for Ed that was published in the Boston Globe. Someone who knew him better than I. I leave you with its closing sentence, which matches perfectly my own recollection of Ed. A gentler soul never lived. Mm.